Hey guys, it's Kelly. Welcome back. So today's video is going to be just a fun, easy, lighthearted video because I feel like that's what we all need right now. And I just want to talk about makeup trends, and I'm going to share some unpopular opinions, makeup trends that I love, but I feel like the majority of people don't. I thought this could be a fun little discussion starter. I'd love to hear from you guys down below what your thoughts are on these. Also, I'm not officially making this a tag, but if you do have a YouTube channel and you want to film this, I would be so excited to see your answers. So unofficially, I tag you. It's not really a tag video, but if you want to film it, please go ahead. I would love to hear everyone else's thoughts on this. So let's go ahead and hop into it. My first one is matte skin. And I feel like not a lot of people like matte skin. But personally, I really do. Like, I prefer my foundation and everything to have a matte finish. Now, not a completely flat finish where it looks unhealthy and it just looks cakey, but not that shiny either. And I think maybe I have kind of two reasons behind this. The first one is, even though these days my skin is like normal to leaning dry, and in the winter definitely more on the dry side, when I was younger, as a teenager, I had very oily skin. So now whenever I see like really glowy skin, I just think oily. But on other people, I don't necessarily think that. It's mostly just myself. Like when my skin is very, very, very dewy, I just feel like I need to blot. So for that reason, it's hard for me to get down with like super dewy, glowy skin. Like don't get me wrong, I like it in concentrated areas, like in a highlighted spot, but I don't want my whole skin, especially my forehead, my nose, my chin. Please do not be dewy, but my cheeks, you can be a little bit dewy. And I feel like the second reason for this is because I film YouTube videos, and on camera, if you are even a little bit dewy, it just reflects on the light so much that you're gonna look really shiny. So I'll have times I'll get comments like, oh, you look so glowy today. And I'm like, in person, I'm like kind of glowy, but on camera, it's so emphasized. So I tend to wear a lot more powder and a lot more matte products when I film. So because of that reason, I tend to be more drawn to them. But I would love to hear from you guys down below because I feel like so many people feel very strongly about dewy foundations. And honestly, my preference probably sits more in the satiny zone. I mean, I have days where I like some glow, but for the most part, I really love a matte look. All right, number two. I know a lot of people feel very strongly about this, but I love shimmers in the crease. Now, this is like a newfound love for me, probably in the last year. I used to follow the rules of makeup where, you know, you do mattes in the crease, shimmers on the lid, they don't mix, they don't move around. I have just fallen in love with a shimmer in the crease. I feel like not only does it kind of take away some of the structure of the look and make it look more undone, but also I feel like it can be flattering to eye shapes. And maybe that's the reason I like it so much. I have smaller eyes, they are slightly hooded. I have like one eye that's very hooded and one eye that's kind of hooded. But on my eyes, if I'm just putting a shimmer on the lid, like when my eyes are open, you really don't see that shimmer. So I like to just take that shimmer everywhere, have a little bit of a glow. Now don't get me wrong, I still usually start with a matte in the crease to kind of build up the look. But eventually when I'm laying that shimmer down on the lid, I'll just kind of dust it around because it looks so effortless. I think that's the word I'm looking for. Effortless. And honestly, these days I've been doing some looks where I just skip a matte shade and just kind of put one shimmer on the lid and then blow it out everywhere, and I'm obsessed with the way that looks these days. So let me know down below, do you guys ever put shimmers in your crease? Do you like that? I know that's like eyeshadow rule number one, only mattes go in the crease, but I've kind of been into the shimmery look these days. All right, the feather eyebrow. I love the feather brow, and I'm gonna try to find a photo and insert it on the screen so we can get a good visual of it. Now, I don't really have a lot of eyebrows naturally. My natural brows are very, very blonde, so to achieve this type of look is tricky for me, so it's not necessarily something that I wear, but I love it on other people, and I know not everyone does. When I did my hot takes video back in the fall, that was a lot of the submissions. I hate feather brows. I don't like the way feathery brows look. Feathery brows just look so messy and undone. And again, I agree that they do, but that's kind of why I like them. So let me know, how do you do your brows? Do you prefer a little more structure? Do you prefer a little more feathery? I mean, personally, I kind of do my brows somewhere in the middle, but if I could achieve that feathery brow look with my lack of eyebrows, I would be doing that. All right, warm toned bronzer. I love it. I love it. Whenever I'm watching like bronzer reviews, if a bronzer is ever kind of warm toned, I feel like a lot of people will mention that as a con. And this definitely comes down to your skin tone, your undertone, and the look you're trying to achieve, but a warm tone bronzer, for me, is like your best friend. Because if it has a little bit of a red undertone to it, it's going to make your cheeks look a lot more like they were hit by the sun. Like, cool tones are more so for creating shadows and structure. And, you know, sometimes depending on your skin tone, you still might prefer a cool toned bronzer. But personally, I love that kind of reddish bronzer. Like today, I mean, I went kind of subtle with the makeup today. I wanted the focus to be on the orange lip, but I'm wearing this Koki bronzer. And I mean, this is a pretty warm toned bronzer. It definitely has kind of like, not the most red undertone, but definitely a lot of orange and warmth to the undertone. And don't get me wrong, I don't want my bronzer to be straight up orange where I look like I have on a really bad self tan, but having a little bit of warmth in the bronzer, in my opinion, contributes to that sun-kissed look that a lot of us are trying to achieve with our bronzer application. So I'm team warm bronzer, warm or neutral. Cool tones, I sometimes will use, you know, to contour, but I really don't want my bronzer to be that cool toned. Maybe if I had a very, very cool undertone, I would. But I kind of like the warmth. Honestly, side note, this was not one of my original categories listed, but I even feel the same way about hair. Like, I kind of like when my hair is a little quote unquote brassy. Like, I like when the color has a little bit of warmth to it. I mean, I don't really have any blonde in my hair right now. I'm more brunette with some pink at the bottom, but I kind of do like when my hair starts to pull a little bit yellow. I mean, not too yellow, but have a little bit of that warmth because I just feel like it's so bright and warm and flattering. Sometimes too cool toned of hair, I'm not into. And I know that isn't a popular opinion. A lot of people would look at some of the blonde in my hair at times and be like, oh, it's a little bit too yellow. Maybe you want to tone that. I kind of like it. All right, heavy blush. I love that look. Now, I don't wear it with every makeup look. Like, there are days when I want a heavier blush, and then there are days like today where I keep the face a little bit subtle. And I try not to do a heavy blush if I have a heavy eye or a heavy lip. I tend to pick like one focal point for the makeup, sometimes two, but if you're doing a lot of eyes and a lot of blush, sometimes it can be a lot to look at. So I tend to pick one or the other, but okay, I feel like 2020 people are getting into blush, which makes me so happy because blush for me is like one of the best steps when it comes to makeup. It will liven up your face. It is just, it brings so much of a youthful glow to everyone's skin. And whenever I hear people say they don't like blush, I just feel like you haven't found the right shade yet because I was the same way for a while. I would wear these like rosy blushes and they didn't work for my skin tone. They didn't flatter me. But now that I've found more like pinky blushes, blush is my best friend. There's no such thing as too much blush. And I feel like that's a good tip for going to work. I get a lot of questions about like work makeup, and I know a lot of us are working from home right now, but that, I think if you are in a rush in the morning and you're trying to look put together, you don't have to do a lot of makeup, but if you apply a lot of blush, I just feel like everyone looks instantly put together. And the last one is a bare lower lash line. Now, I think the reason that I like this is because I have smaller eyes, and I get comments whenever I mention that, people be like, your eyes aren't that small, but it's because I don't put color on my lower lash line. You can see, sometimes I do, sometimes I'll line my waterline and everything and my eyes appear a lot smaller because it really just closes off your eyes. But if you're trying to look very awake, have very opened eyes, skipping that lower lash line just lifts everything up so much. Now, I will say, over the last few months, I'm kind of getting into lower lash liner and shadow. I'm really starting to like that very like smoked out, sultry look. But I don't do it for every day. It's kind of more of a sultry look for me when I'm going a little bit more glam. So if you guys always wear eyeliner on the bottom, try just doing the top of your eyes. Have like a heavy liner on the top, nothing on the bottom, and that's just going to lift your eyes up so much. I know not a lot of people like this. I hear people say, oh, it looks incomplete. Personally, I love like a heavy lid, crease, everything, and then nothing on the bottom. All right, now I want to hear from you guys. What do you think of any of these trends? Are there any makeup trends that are really popular that aren't for you, or vice versa? Something that not a lot of people like to apply their makeup this way, but you love it. It makes a huge difference for you. I want to hear down below. And like I said in the beginning, if you do have a YouTube channel, I definitely tag you to film this video. I hope everyone is doing well, staying safe, and I will go ahead and see you in my next one. Bye.